I first recognized that I had mental health issues or problems when I was a teenager. I had suicidal thoughts and I didn't really know what to do with them. I grew up like a lot of people thinking that committing suicide was a crime because you have the committing right before it. I've changed my vernacular, a lot of people have, and now it's died by suicide. And I first started having those thoughts in my teenage years. And in hindsight, there are some signs that I missed growing up of anxiety that I just didn't understand. I had nicknames as a kid of Worrywart. I was constantly concerned about so many things. Now I know that's because I have anxiety. I always wanted to know what people thought of me. I always wanted to know what was going on because I thought people were thinking bad things about me. Again, hindsight's 20/20. I started getting treatment when I was in the military, and subsequently I did have an honorable medical discharge from the military for my mental health issues. When I got home, I didn't do the right things and seek help like I should have. I kind of hid behind my mask and pretended to be strong and brave when deep down I was not. I was breaking pretty hard. And I've had some falls over the last 20 years or so since I've separated from the military, the Air Force. I come from a Marine family. And it took 12 friends taking their lives over that span when I got out of the military, and watching the struggles of friends and family as well as my own. And about a year and a half, 2 years ago, depression really had its grip pretty tight on me. And it was at that point that it was either get out of bed or stay in bed and die. I had lost about 40 pounds. I wasn't eating, I just wasn't healthy. And I tried half-heartedly some outpatient programs, some new medications. It didn't work. I eventually resigned to the fact that I needed to go to inpatient and I needed something stronger and I needed more barriers to protect myself from myself almost. I wasn't having unsafe thoughts. I couldn't live. And at that point, my girlfriend, my family, the medical team that I was working with convinced me to admit myself to an inpatient program. And that's really where my life changed. I learned so much about myself. I learned how to utilize the strength that's inside of me that I've known I've had for other reasons and really apply it to what's going through my mental health and my challenges that I still have. There's no cure for depression, anxiety, and PTSD. You can only hope to live a better life. And I do that by making sure I'm taking care of myself, getting plenty of rest. I meditate daily. I see a therapist. I take medications. I wake up before my alarm because of my anxiety. So I spend some time talking myself pretty much down to a good place in my head where I'm not second guessing. I'm nauseous over what did everybody think about all the decisions and things I said yesterday. What do I have on my plate today? What are people going to say if I say this? What if I'm sweating in the middle of this meeting? These are things that go through my head all the time. So I sit and I take a good half hour every morning to parse through those thoughts. And most of the time I get them down on paper in a journal just to clear them out of my head. And honestly, it hasn't been until recently until it really works almost daily for me now. The other day I had a challenging email I received for work and I immediately went to the most negative thought, the most worst case scenario, what was going to happen. And I stopped myself and I took a step back and I analyzed myself and the email. Like, no, this person's new. I'm new. We just need to understand each other. That's all. And rather than get upset or freak out or have anxiety and get nauseous and not sleep, I was able to get a restful night of sleep, have a very productive phone call the next day. And that's how I can look back on that. And it really helps me on my tough days. And when I talk to people, because part of what I do with NAMI New Hampshire is speaking, is I tell them my story, my struggle, and then how I get through things. And I remind people that everybody has the same strength inside. They just need someone to help show them that and pull it out. The biggest thing that gets in the way is the stigma. Yeah. That's one of the things that I thought when I got out of the Air Force was I'm a veteran. I can't break down and tell people I have depression. It took me 15 years to even tell people I was honorably discharged with the medical because of fear of people looking down on me, losing jobs, not getting jobs, losing my children. You know, that's something that I was just in the Air Force and I didn't see combat. So for these men and women that are in the military now that are overseas doing things that we can't even put our minds to, now they're coming home and they're living with what happened overseas. And if this person is entrusted to protect, how is that person expected to ask for help? A protector shouldn't be viewed as weak. That's how people view a protector, a guardian, a bodyguard. That's what I think is happening. I think that our veterans need to understand, and the military needs to help them understand, that this does not make them any less of a warrior. It makes them just as much, or if not a greater warrior, because they're understanding themselves and they want to get the help that they desperately need. For anybody that's out there and experiencing crisis or unsafe thoughts, you know, remember that you are loved. There was a time where I felt that way, and I still do at times. I love you. I love myself. It takes a lot of work, and it's okay if it's hard.